Okay, so in the last lecture, we have studied what is closed set, definition of closed set, definition of limit points. When we say that limit point, a particular point in the metric space is the limit point of a subset of a metric space that we have seen, then what is meant by derived set? Derived set is what? It is a set of all limit points of a subset A of the metric space X. And we have done one very important theorem that it is a characterization of the closed set. What do you mean characterization of the closed set? Set is closed. Every if and only statement when you write, it is the characterization of that concept. It means you have wrote in that result, set A of a metric space X is closed if and only if A dash is subset of it. In other words, we can say that the set A of a metric space X is closed if and only if it contains all its limit points. So now you have two different ways to prove that set is closed. One way is you show that its complement is open. If complement of the set is open, then the given set is closed. And second is this result now, that if you can show that the set A contains all its limit points, then also the set is closed. So these two results we have seen. Now today we will concentrate on the definition of limit point. What we have said there is this, that suppose XB is a metric space, okay, and A is subset of X, then point X belonging to capital X is a limit point of A. Limit point of A. What is the definition? If and only what? For all R greater than 0, the open sphere SXR contains at least one point of A other than X. Now in a mathematical way you can write this as SXR minus X other than X we want. So minus X and its intersection with A is empty. Is non-empty. Then you will say that this X is a limit point of the set. So what we are saying here is very important idea, that whatever open sphere you draw around X, it contains at least one point of A other than X. Okay. Now suppose you have a point which contains no point of A other than X. Here we are saying it contains at least one, because we are saying intersection of SXR minus X. Minus X you have done, so you are considering points of the open sphere. You know SXR is an open sphere centered at X, so it always contains X, no doubt in that. You remove X from that, so punctured open sphere we have taken. And that punctured open sphere with A, its intersection is non-empty. So other than X, it contains at least one point. Now suppose you have a point X belonging to metric space, X belonging to capital X. But what is the property of that point? You have a open sphere around that point. Then that open sphere contains at least one point X of A. Then what will happen? Is X limit point of the set A? Is X limit point? No. Because why? If it is a limit point, then it should contain at least one point of A other than X. Now here we are saying it does not contain any point of A other than X. Then X is not a limit point. Such a point is called isolated point. So definition of isolated point. See, many times we are taking it in a wrong way. We always take it in this way, that when it is a not limit point, it is isolated point. It's not so. See, what we are saying is, in case of the definition of limit point, we are saying X is a limit point if it contains open sphere around X contains at least one point of A other than X. Here we are saying open sphere around X contains only one point X belonging to it. Okay, then it is isolated point. So we will write the definition of isolated point. We should understand it properly, what is meant by isolated point. So point X belonging to capital X is an isolated point. Isolated point of A subset of X if there exists open sphere around X or center at X containing no point of A other than X. So, as an example, we will consider the set 0 and 1 upon N, where N belongs to capital. Right. Now what are the elements in this set? You know, this set is similar to this. Actually, if you list the elements in this set, they are 0, 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, etc. 1 upon N is a general term, and then and so on. So these are all the elements of that set. Now we can see here that 0 is the limit point of this set. We always have done this. 0 is the limit point, why? Because you check any epsilon, if you take radius epsilon and if you consider open sphere around 0, then it will contain at least one point of this set other than 0. So 0 is the limit point. Is one limit point? If I take, see, now this is, if you draw, last time also we have drawn this figure, this is 0, this is 1 half, this is 1. I want to check whether 1 is limit point. See, I can draw, because after this it will be what? 1 by 3, it is point here. So there is no point between 1 and 1. So if I take radius say 0.25, if I take R at 0.25 and draw open sphere around 1, what will happen? It will not contain any point of A other than 1. 1 is there. 1 is in this set, but I can draw open sphere around 1 which will not contain any point of A other than 1. So 1 is isolated point. Similarly, 1 half will be isolated point. Similarly, 1 by 3 will be isolated point. So every point in this set other than 0 is isolated point. 0 is the limit point. So this is an excellent example of isolated points. So here we can say 1 belongs to, suppose I name this set as say A, and we are treating this as a subset of R. So R, T is the metric space that we are considering. D is the usual metric. So that is the metric space R, T, and A is the set. 1 belongs to A is an isolated point. Isolated point as if R is taken at 0.25, then S1 0.25 will be what? What is the open sphere around 1 with radius 0.25 in case of R? It is 0.75 to 1.25. Now this open sphere does not contain any point of A other than 1. Right? No point of A other than 1 it contains. So 1 is isolated point. So this neighborhood does not contain any point of A other than. So 1 is isolated point. one is isolated. Because it is not, see, it is not, limit point is not the only necessary thing. What is important is, it is the only point in that open sphere which is contained in it. See, if I consider, say, point, now this set, same set we consider, and suppose I take point 2 belonging to x, 2 is a real number, 2 is definitely not limit point of this. Because why? If I take epsilon equal to 1 suppose, or if I take say, if I take epsilon to be 1, then what? If I take epsilon to be 1, then what is S2 epsilon? It will be what? 2 minus 1 to 2 plus 1, 1 to 3, this open interval. So this open interval also does not contain any point of this. But here, important thing is 2 also is not the limit of this. Okay, so if you casually say that the point which is not limit point is isolated point, is wrong. This is also not a limit point of this state. But this is not isolated point, because isolated point actually belongs to the set, but it is not limit point. This is the distinction between the two things. Here 2 is not the limit of this set itself. So 2 is not limit point, is okay. It is not limit point only. It cannot be considered as an isolated point. For isolated point, that point which we are saying isolated point must belong to the set under consideration. So this is the main issue in isolated points. So whenever you are considering, now suppose I take A as just 1 upon n. Suppose I take A as 1 upon n, n belonging to capital N. 0 is excluded now. Now what you can say about this set? It contains what? It contains 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, etc. 1 upon general term, so on. Now every point is isolated point. Here every point is isolated point. And whenever you consider isolated point, then so here what we can conclude, every point of A, you take this as, this is taken as A, so you consider this as A dash. So every point of A dash is isolated point of A dash. Okay, so suppose now you have a subset. Now we will generalize this idea, and this is very important thing now. It means what? Our set is a discretized set now. It is a discretized set. Discretely elements are present. Discrete in the sense what? Whenever you are walking by using elements in that set, then you have to lift your leg. If your set is continuous, like open interval 0, 1 or closed interval 1, 2, 3, then those are not discrete sets. Elements in that set are continuous appearing. But here 1, then directly 1 half, then directly 1 by 3. So if you have to walk by using these elements, first your leg is on 1, then you have to put it on 1 half. All the elements in between 1 and 1 half are not there. So this is the discretization. Discretely elements are present in the set. So whenever you are saying that every element in the set is an isolated point, then what? The set is actually discrete type of set. So there are gaps between the elements. This is what it includes. Okay. So suppose now we have XD, a matrix space. Okay. And A is subset of X. And suppose X is isolated point of A. X is isolated point of A. Or not only A, suppose you take whole matrix space X, and if every point in that matrix space is isolated point, then what will happen? What is your answer to that? What I am saying is, your matrix space, instead of taking A, forget A, suppose you have a matrix space X, D, and each X belonging to capital X. Each X belonging to capital X is an isolated point of X. Then what? What does it mean? Forget this A itself. A is a subset of X. So instead of saying A and all those things, we take this as an example that you have a matrix space capital X with a matrix B, and every element in that matrix space is isolated point. Okay, then what can you say about singletonness? What can you say about singletonness? Actually, what this means is you are knowing that X is isolated point. It means what? You can find R greater than 0 such that if you take open sphere around X with radius R, it will contain only one point of A, and that is X. Okay? What does it mean? SXR is just single than X because it contains only one point of A other than X, one point of this, it does not contain any point actually. Isolated means it does not contain any point of capital X other than X. So SXR will be just single than X. But this is open sphere, and that open sphere is single than X. We know from previous results that every open sphere is an open set. So here single than X is open set. So whenever you have a matrix space X, D, where every point is isolated point, then the singleton set X, suppose X is that isolated point, then singleton set X is an open set. Now as singleton set is open, then you can say that whole matrix space X is union of open sets. Because suppose that matrix space contains 100 elements, then there will be 100 singleton sets and their union, and we know arbitrary union of open sets is open. So whole matrix space will be open. Singleton set is open, whole matrix space is open. In short, whenever this type of matrix space is there, we can say that whenever you have a matrix space in which every element of that matrix space is an isolated point, then what we can say? It is a discrete matrix space. And then every subset of that discrete matrix space will be open. Okay, so such a matrix space, x, d, where each element or each element of X is an isolated point, then every subset A of X is open set. And when you say every subset is open, suppose A is any subset. So if A is subset of X, you know with this condition that X, every point in X is isolated point, that is the rest there. And if A is subset of X, this implies A is open. What will happen to A dash? Complement of A. A complement. A complement also is a subset of X. When A is subset of X, A complement is also a subset of X. So by this rule, A complement is also open. A complement is open means what does it imply? A is closed. Right? So whenever you have a matrix space, very important thing we are saying now, if you have a matrix space in which every subset is means every point in the matrix space, every point is an isolated point, then every subset A of that matrix space is open also, closed also. And that is why some authors define discrete matrix space as this, that every set is open and closed. Such a matrix space is a discrete matrix space. This is another definition of a discrete matrix space. So we will note it now. So see, this is important conclusion now. You have XD, each X belonging to capital X is isolated point of X. If A is subset, see, A is, means if you take A as a subset of X, then it implies A is open also, A is closed also. And such a matrix space, as we have said in previous part, that such a matrix space is a discrete matrix. So there is another definition by which discrete matrix space is defined. Discrete matrix space. What is that? A matrix space X, D metric space x comma d is said to be discrete if every subset of x is open in x comma d, okay, and hence closures. This is the discussion about isolated parts. I think in a nutshell we should remember this, that it is not that every point which is not limit point is isolated point. It is not so. It should not be the limit point, but the point belongs to the set where it is isolated. An example we have written 0, 1 upon in that example. And now whenever every point in a metric space is isolated point, it is a discrete nature. That metric space has a discrete nature. And such a metric space can you consider. Every subset of that metric space is both open and closed. So using that idea, discrete metric space is also defined like this. Actually, this is the classical definition of a discrete metric space. Now, whenever you have a metric space, and if on that suppose I define dxy as 1 when x is not equal to y, and dvxy is 0 if and only if x is equal to y. Well, with that definition, that metric space is called discrete metric space. But whenever you consider metric topology, this is the topological definition of a discrete metric space, that every set is both open and closed, then it is a discrete metric space. Okay. Now with all this discussion, we will go to the new theme, next topic. It is the closure of a set. Closure of a set. Okay, so what is now closure of the set? It is very simple. Definition is very simple. What you do is, let X be a metric space and A be the subset of X. Okay, so definition. Let X comma D be metric space. A be the subset of X. The closure of A denoted by A bar is union of A and all the limit points of A, so A bar is A union A dash. We know A dash is what? Set of limit points, that is called derived set. So this is the definition. So what you do is take a set and all its limit points. So for example, we'll support this definition by examples. Now suppose I take the usual matrix space first, or you take R comma D, usual metric space. So D is usual distance. And first example, suppose I take capital A as open interval AB or closed interval AB, or this way, or straightway closed interval. Then what is the closure of this space? Now these are continuous steps, right? These are continuous. In case of upper interval, maybe boundary points A and B are not there. A and B are not included, but they are limit points. We know. Whenever we study limit points, these examples we have done. So what is the set of all limit points of open interval AB, closed interval AB? Every year, in every case, set of limit points. So if this is your A, A dash is always what? Closed interval AB. And so any A you take, what is A union A dash? Closed interval. Correct? So closure of all these sets is a closed interval. Open interval AB, when you consider its closure, is closed interval AB. Right? Now, second example we will do. Say, A is suppose a set of natural numbers. You know, natural numbers is subset of R. So, we can think of this. What was the set of limit points of set of natural numbers? What was the set of limit points of? No natural number is a limit point. And so we have written there that in this case A dash is empty. Set of limit points of natural number sets, empty. Set of limit points of Z, empty. Remember. Okay, so what happens now here? A dash is empty. So what is remark? A union A dash. So it is N union MD. So it is A bar, definition of A bar is A union A dash. Okay, so whenever you say that I am taking natural number set as a subset of R, then its set of limit points of set of natural numbers is nothing, empty set. And that is why N union MT will be N. Correct? Now, next thing is you consider a third example, say Q, which is subset of R. What is the set of limit points of Q? Whole set of A. Because every rational number is a limit point of set of rational numbers. Also, every rational number. We have given this logic that you take any rational number and you take whatever epsilon you want and consider epsilon neighborhood around that rational number. It will contain a point of the rational numbers. It will contain points from the set of rational numbers. And so, every rational number is also limit point of this set. Every rational number is also limit point of this set. So, whenever I take set of limit points, Q dash, is equal to R. And so what is Q bar? It is Q set itself union its limit points. So it is R. So closure of set of rational numbers is R. Fourth example. If you take suppose a set, a usual set, 1 upon N, N belonging to capital N. Suppose I take this set as A, which is subset of R. What is its closure? What is the closure? What is the limit point of this set? Zero. So A bar is A union A dash. So we know zero is the limit point of this set. So it is A union singleton zero. This will be the closure of that set. So the idea is very clear. What you do is consider limit points, add the limit points to the given set. A union A dash is A bar. This is the, these are simple examples. Okay. Now coming to the this concept, closure. See, always you should now remember that the relation between because now closure we have studied, interior we have studied. In case of open sets, interior. In case of closed set, closure. So this similarity you must observe. You know the interior of the set is what? Set of all interior points of the set. And we know that every interior point belongs to the set. So in short, no point outside the set can be interior point of the set. But a point outside the set can be limit point of the set. Once you must understand this. Then if you consider interior of the set, this, now in case of you consider this, suppose XB is a metric space. And A is subset of X. Okay, proper subset of X. A is proper subset of X. I want to find what is the relation between A interior, A and A closure. What is the relation between these three ideas? A interior is what? It is set of all interior points. So whenever you are given one set, then it may happen that a point belonging to the set is not interior point. Point outside the set being interior point of the set is impossible. No point outside the set can be interior point of the set. But whenever you take an example, simple example you take, closed interval AB, when you consider it as a subset of R, what happens to A and B? Are they interior points or no? What is the A interior of this set? It is what? Open interval AB. And what is closure of this set? Just now we have said, closed interval AB. So now what is the relation between A interior, A and A bar? A interior is subset of A, it is subset of A. So A interior is subset of A, subset of A. Can you tell me or give me an example where all these three things are equal? A interior in general is a subset of A. It is subset of A bar. But when all these three things are equal, it is closed interval AB. This can be the example. Sorry, not closed interval AB. Try to find an example where these three things are equal. A interior must be equal to A. Now when A interior is equal to A, A must be closed. Sorry, A must be open. We have done one result that set is open if and only if A is equal to A interior. So when the set is open, it must be equal to A interior. Okay, and you want to also say, we will prove further, we will prove, and then you can be able to give this example. Okay. Find an example where all these three things are equal. So A interior and A bar, these three things now will come to your in your syllabus. All these things are to be properly done. So you must always know what is the relation between these three things. And can you find an example where A bar, A interior is proper subset of A, is proper subset of A bar. Second example is A interior is equal to A, is equal to A bar. Such things we can try. Different matrix spaces you can take, different subsets of that matrix space we can take. And then find here, see, whenever I want to find A interior, what I have to do? I will find set of points which are interior points of that set. And whenever I want to find A bar, what is to be done? You will calculate limit points of the set and then check union of A and limit points. That gives you A bar. And so it's always important to know these ideas properly. In analysis, when you know the ideas properly, then you can develop many examples. And always remember, mathematics can be understood by collecting lot of examples you must have. Because these examples, if you have, then your ideas become clear. Otherwise, it is just a theory. You will not understand anything by just reading the theoretical part. But whatever concept you are learning, suppose you are learning concept of interior point, immediately you should be able to throw a lot of examples of interior points. What is interior of the set? What is limit point? What, suppose a set is given, then you should be able to find the limit points of that set. This is very crucial that suppose you are given a set, you must be able to immediately find limit points of that set. When you find limit points of the set, you can tell what is A bar. Because A bar is just A union A dash. You just consider limit points and take the union with A. So A union limit points of A. It becomes what? A bar. So A bar and then A interior. You should be able to find set of interior points. What is the, when you will say a point is interior point? When you can find R, there exists R greater than 0, such that if you take open square around that point, it is entirely inside the set. That is interior point. What is limit point? Limit point may not be the point of that set. But if you take any epsilon greater than 0, then Sx epsilon, suppose x is that point, then Sx epsilon will contain a point of the set other than this. And so this type of ideas we have to always, and this, if you are clear with these concepts, then any set and any matrix space whenever it is given, you will be able to find limit points, you will be able to find interior points of that state. This is right. So these ideas, and another thing that whenever you are saying, suppose now this x comma t is a matrix space and you are saying A is subset of X, P is limit point of A. What is our definition? You take any epsilon greater than 0, then it contains at least one point of A other matrix. Now, can you from this definition conclude that every epsilon neighborhood around P contains infinitely many points of A? Can you conclude like this? Whenever I say P is repeat point of the set A, definition tells you that you check any epsilon greater than 0 and consider what you consider, you take epsilon greater than 0 for each. Epsilon greater than 0, what you can, what you always say, Sx epsilon minus x, intersection of this with A is not infinite. So this set A contains, this epsilon neighborhood of x contains at least one point of A other than x. But from this at least, see, this is obvious. For each epsilon greater than 0, so suppose I have this set A, means this x, suppose x. Now this is suppose epsilon, my check. Now this is, you consider R2 as a matrix space, then this will be the open sphere around x. Because R2 open sphere is circle with center and x centers. So this open sphere contains what? At least one point of A other than x. So call that point of A as say x1. Call that point as x1. Now what you do is take the radius epsilon by 2. Take the radius epsilon by 2. And so again what you can say, there will be open sphere with radius epsilon by 2. This is epsilon by 2. This open sphere also will contain point of A other than x. Now this x1 will not be there because x1 is outside this open sphere. So this open sphere also contains a point of A other than x. So call that point as x2. Now take radius as epsilon by 3. Again draw open sphere around x. Now this radius is epsilon by 3. This will also contain point of A other than x. So call that point as x3. How many times this procedure can be repeated? Infinitely many times. Each time you are taking a new point, which is in A, but other than x. So there will be infinitely many points, right? When you take epsilon, any epsilon you take, this procedure you can repeat in case of that epsilon. And so, other way of defining limit point is this, that instead of saying it contains for each epsilon at least one point is there other than x, what people define like this, that every epsilon neighborhood of A means if xp is a matrix space, A is subset of x, then point x belonging to capital X is a limit point of A. Limit point of A. You can only every epsilon neighborhood of every epsilon, what we can say, epsilon open sphere. Every epsilon open sphere centered at x, centered at x, contains infinitely many points of A. Infinitely many distinct points. So this is another very important conclusion, that instead of saying it contains at least one point of A other than x, we can say if you take any epsilon greater than 0, if that particular point is a limit point, then it will contain infinitely many points. That epsilon neighborhood will contain infinitely many points. The literature is distinct from distinct, infinitely many distinct points of A. So this is the crust of the theorem. So this is all about definition of limit points, then definition of closure actually. Then closure is definitely related to limit point, because you take all the limit points, take their union, derived set and original set, union of them is the closure of the set. Now we will prove one result which is analogous to previous result. Previous result is one, we have proved one result about interior of the structure. What you have done in that theorem, you proved four parts here. If you remember, first part of A interior is open set. Means X D is a metric space and A is subset of X. Then about interior of the set we have defined, or we have proved the result, A interior is open set. Here we will say A bar is a closure. A closure of A is a closed set. Then in second part of that result we have proved that A is open if and only if A is equal to A interior. Here we will prove A is closed if and only if A is equal to A bar. Then in the third part of that result we have proved A interior is the largest open set contained in A. Here we will prove A bar is the smallest closed set contained in A. And the fourth part in that result was A interior is union of all open subsets contained in A. Here we will prove A bar is the intersection of all closed subsets of X contained in A. Like this, analogous result we have to prove, and I think that we will prove in the next lecture.